It was pretty normal at first, but my father died February 9th, 2004, when I was 4 years old. And I just knew that it was going to be a different ball game, but I had to be stronger within myself because I was the oldest of three other people. So my main goal was just to keep them strong also.
Being a man of the house at an early age really brought a big role for me. My father, he was really never there, so I had to, you know, help out more. Sometimes maybe put school to the side and help out with the family more. That was also a real impact on the life as well because it made me who I am today.
The water pipes in our house got stolen, which left our entire house without water. So I remember going to the park that was next door with these big water jugs and filling them up every day so we could have water to drink, to take a bath in, to shower, to cook, things like basic needs of life. And that was pretty hard growing up. When I was in seventh grade, we had moved to a different house and my mom had picked up a third shift job. She wasn't really there at the house all the time, so I was really the one in the house taking care of my brothers. And I felt like it was my responsibility to step up because my mom always looked at me as the person to step up and take control of things. So I didn't want to let her down, so I stepped up and took leadership.
My family wasn't exactly stable. Like, we would move from Liberia to Guinea, from Guinea to Mali, and it was too much moving. And it's like, once you get settled in and you make one new friend, you get snatched away and you have to go start over somewhere else. It wasn't exactly what you would imagine for your average six-year-old. Like, you're thinking about friends and colors and rainbows and stuff, but mine, it was war and it's just hard times and seeing death right in front of you and having to take all of that in.
Sophomore year, I realized like, wow, like it was stuff that I really needed to do. So as I started to go to my CYC advisor, she really pushed me. She kept me on track. She motivated me to, well, look, this is where you're at right now. And if you want to go to college, you have to do these things.
And these experiences, such as like the water being out the house or having to work, those taught me that things may not always go your way, but you can't stop there. So you have to keep going.
My past experiences, most people will use those as an excuse. Like, hey, I've been through a war, give me a break, let me do what I want. No, I use that as a point of reflection and also a way to better myself.
She provides help and a lot of hope. Sometimes I come in there, I might be smiling, but on the inside I'm really down. And when we really get a chance to sit down and talk, that hope like comes out. Like there's no more hurt inside. What I'm feeling on the outside is what I'm feeling on the inside.
CYC taught me that it's not, you don't have to think about now, but think about your tomorrow. And I've been doing that. They told me how to think about my tomorrow. They taught me how to look into my colleges, look into what I wanted to do, and they've helped me do that also. My advisor, anytime I needed a ride anywhere, Ms. Weaver was there. From college orientations to going to get a driver's license, she's always there for people. So I can say CYC goes above and beyond what it's even mapped out for its students. It's doing more than what it should, so it's helped me come a long way.
See, I always looked at CYC as like a trampoline. If I was to ever fall, if I ever needed something, I could always rely on the CYC to bounce me back up to where I was. So if I ever needed help with like homework or anything, I knew I could always run to the CYC. Or if I ever needed a question answered about college, I knew where to go first, which was to find either Miss Stephanie or see if Miss Kayla was in the building. I always knew where to find them at. So the CYC definitely helped me a lot.
CYC has pushed me to just, you know what, no matter what happens in your life, keep pushing. Reach for your goal, and if your goal is education, don't let that stop you. You know, like, education is your key to the world is what Mr. Thornton always says. So just use that key and it can open so many doors for you. So CYC is like a mentor, a social worker, like everything in one for me. It's like family, like you're a part of a big group of people who care about nothing but your success. They bring the best of you out.